Hello, I'm Ty Mason of the DiabetesCouncil.com, researcher, writer, and I have type 2 diabetes. Now, I want to emphasize that my perspective is coming from one with type 2 and not type 1 diabetes. Our channel is primarily for those with type 2 diabetes and pre-diabetes. Today, I want to answer the question, what is postprandial blood glucose? And why should people with pre-diabetes know about it? After you watch the video today, I invite you to check out the description box for my new ebook. This is one of the most comprehensive diabetes meal planning books you can find anywhere. It contains diabetes-friendly meals and recipes, recipes for different goals, such as 800 to 1800 calories per day meal plans, diabetes meal planning tips and tricks. There are also tons of diabetes-friendly recipes for everyone. There are a lot of big terms out there, aren't there? And you really need to know what some of those terms are and why they are important. One such term, postprandial blood glucose. Now, the term postprandial glucose might sound like jargon, but it literally means sugar after the meal. So what we are talking about here is the blood glucose reading at about 1 to 2 hours after a large meal. Now that part is pretty simple to answer, but why should you know what that number is? Well, some of you with prediabetes are checking your blood sugar in the mornings. Some might not be. It really depends on your control and what your doctor thinks is best. But if you're only testing first thing in the morning, you might be missing the full picture. In my research, I came across an interesting article in Everyday Health. Some of what I'm about to say about PPG, or postprandial glucose, is from that article. You see, the first morning glucose level check is usually the lowest of the day, and checking only in the morning is kind of like purposefully blindfolding yourself to only see the best case scenario. If you want to see a more complete picture, mix it up. Check your glucose level at various times during the day. Now, the ADA, or the American Diabetes Association, recommends checking the blood sugar levels before eating, that's a fasting blood sugar, and then again 1 to 2 hours after the beginning of the meal, which is postprandial glucose. Now, particularly do this if the target A1C goals aren't being met. The test after the meal, called the postprandial glucose test, you might need to test your blood sugar at other times during the day or after certain activities, depending on the information you and your medical team are trying to put together. You see, that test is very, very important to see what meals are doing, especially certain meals, to your blood glucose. Now, those PPG numbers are affected by a number of variables, including what you eat, how active you are, your insulin sensitivity, and how quickly food moves through your stomach. The postprandial glucose gives us information about how the body is able to manage the blood glucose after a meal. It informs us if blood glucose has returned to normal or if it's up or down after the meal intake. Now, when blood sugar spikes after meals and stays high, well, that can make it difficult for you to achieve your A1C and other blood sugar control goals. Now, that's according to guidelines published by the American Association of Clinical Endocrinologists. If your A1C continues to be higher than your target goal, your chance of developing complications increases, especially your chance of developing type 2. So the PPG can help troubleshoot those problems. By measuring your postprandial glucose, you can determine whether dietary modifications or pre-meal bolus insulin is needed to reduce these spikes. Now, if you have prediabetes, that's probably not going to happen. But if you achieve your pre-meal glucose targets, but your A1C remains above target, then you really need to monitor that very, very closely and talk to your doctor about it. Learning how to count carbs can help you achieve your PP goals. Carbs contribute significantly more to your postprandial glucose than fat and protein, and so checking it regularly can help you figure out the best balance of carbs, fats, and proteins. Now, I know this is a lot to take in. And for some of you, your doctor is not having you take a postprandial glucose. But at some point, you may. So I hope that this has been informative for you. Don't forget to get my new ebook, and please subscribe to our channel for many more videos like this one in the future. I want to thank you so much for watching. I'm Ty Mason.